Good morning, students and staff. Today is Tuesday, February 16th, 2021. It's day one. Please stand and listen to our national anthem, followed by a moment of silent reflection. Please be seated. We would like to start by acknowledging that we're on the traditional territories of the Wendat, the Haudenosaunee, and the Anishinaabe peoples, whose presence here continues to this day. We would also like to acknowledge that this is the treaty lands of the First Nations of the Williams Treaty and thank them and other Indigenous peoples for sharing this land with us. We'd also like to acknowledge the Chippewas of Georgina Island First Nation as our closest Indigenous community and our partners in education. So today we were planning to come back to school, but there is a lot of snow outside, and so you are learning virtually with your classroom teacher today instead of being back here at school face to face. But we're really, really looking forward to having you back to school tomorrow. Before we talk about our return tomorrow, I just wanted to remind you that today's Mindful Minute is about feelings. And so we've been doing these mindful minutes throughout the month of February, and we'll continue to do this. So growing up, many of us were taught that certain emotions are wrong. Perhaps that anger was bad, that joy was uncivilized, or that it wasn't okay to cry. So instead of accepting our emotions as part of being human, we learned to push them away. Just as nature experiences sunshine and showers, mindfulness invites us to meet all of our emotions with openness and curiosity. Even if the rain forces us to cancel our outdoor plans, we can use the opportunity to snuggle up quietly inside while it nourishes a nearby vegetable garden. Meditation helps us make space to experience our feelings and respond with care and appreciation. And so for this mindfulness activity, your teacher is going to invite you to sit in a comfortable position, and there is music, sound that you're going to hear, and there are some reflective questions that they will guide us through. So we hope that this is a helpful mindful minute about feelings for today. So with our return to school, this is for all of our students, but also reminders for parents, as there's been a lot of information recently shared with everybody. And we did send out, the school sent out an EDSBE message on Friday with some really, really important reminders for our parents. So some of the changes are that if a student or staff member has one of the symptoms of COVID-19, they're required to stay at home from school and childcare and get tested for COVID-19 at an assessment center. And so a link has been shared with you to the COVID-19 screening list that you need to go through with your parent or guardian every single day. So for me, I have two girls that go to York Region Schools. And so we've printed out that checklist and we will be checking it every single day. Okay, there's a lot of other information beyond that information about the one symptom that was shared with parents and guardians. And we won't cover that now, but that's for your parent or guardian to review. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact the school. And so there are a few things that are going to be different for you as a student here at school. One is that all students, grades 1 to 12, need to wear a mask at all times. Okay. And our kindergarten students are strongly encouraged to wear masks. And most of you have been wearing your masks even outside at recess time, but now you have to. So that's really, really important. You're also, and this is for parents and guardians as well as students, you're discouraged from congregating before or after school. So that would be, before school or after school, gathering with friends or friends outside. Again, we need to be very, very careful, and so we're asking you not to do this for the safety of yourselves and for everyone else. Also, you should, as a student, you should be wearing York Region Public Health is recommending that you wear three-layer masks, and details about what this would look like has been sent to you. Two-layer masks are permitted if they're clean and fit appropriately. And so, just a reminder for families dropping off and picking up the children at school, you're reminded to wear masks and not to congregate on school property. So, even our family members that are coming to school, you also need to make sure that you wear a mask as well. And of course, we're always going to remind you about proper hand hygiene, making sure that we're washing hands on a regular basis. So, just for our students and for our parents and guardians, just a reminder that you need to be careful to make sure that you have everything that you need when you come to school in the morning, because we can't receive any items, water bottles, shoes, homework left at home, extra clothing, changes of clothing. All of this needs to be in your backpack when you arrive at school. And so preparing this the night before you go to bed and leaving it at the front door is really, really important, because we regret that we cannot receive anything at the door, as has been the case this entire fall. It's important that you check the weather. Keep in mind that our students are outside for 20 minutes in the morning, and sorry, 30 minutes in the morning and 40 minutes in the afternoon, and you need to be dressed for that. And so, please, parents and guardians, if you do have extra gloves, please send them just in case they get wet. Again, we're not able to receive things during the day, okay, including water bottles, anything like that. So, you do need to make sure that you send everything to school. And just for our students, just want to let you know, we have an additional water dispenser upstairs. So, we have one on the side near Miss Felix's room, and we also have another one on the other side near Miss Lung's room. So that was installed over the break, or will be installed soon. So that's really great news. And just a reminder for our students, please remember to bring back any technology that was borrowed from the school from your classroom. Please bring it back to your classroom teacher, any technology that was borrowed over the break. We hope that you have a great week. We're looking forward to seeing you back at school tomorrow, which is Wednesday, because today, after the snow, we're not at school. But we're really, really excited to see you back at school. Have a great week.